This is my friend Marianne Danfelser in Albuquerque, New Mexico. And I lived here back in the 90s. And I treated her for sacroiliac joint dysfunction. And we had a successful outcome in 3 visits. And she has a very interesting and somewhat humorous story to tell. And I appreciate her chutzpah in doing what she did. So here she is.
Okay, here's my story. I was working as an educational consultant internationally. And I had been in Japan for 3 months. And while I was there, I suddenly reached a point where I could not sit down, stand up. I couldn't do anything. And I think it was from sitting on the floors in all these fancy Japanese restaurants. As a result, when I returned home, I thought, I have to do something to solve this problem. And so I started out with regular medical doctor, and he was an osteopathic doctor. And then I ended up with the recommendation that I see physical therapists. So I started with that, and I was in an office with a doctor, and I won't mention his name, and he said, oh, I could fix this. What you need is 5 levels of injections in your back. Well, the problem, I kept saying, is not in my back. It's in my rear end, and it's killing me. And so, anyway, I said, okay, I'll let you do the injections. He did. It did absolutely nothing for me. So then, after maybe 5 different physical therapists, I ended up with one that I had known from years and years back. And I thought, this person can really help me, because the reputation of this person was very good. And so I had an appointment, went over. And what happened was, I had a whole series of exercises prescribed. And I was to see the therapist 3 times a week. And I was riding bicycles in her office. I was standing against the wall and doing squats, which I could hardly do because the pain was excruciating. Then they had me on the table doing a lot of exercises. Well, after several months of that, and my saying, this is not working, and I don't think you're on the right track. Well, I was laying on the table in the office, and I think the therapist felt like, I don't know what else to do with this woman. Maybe she's nuts. You know, maybe there's nothing wrong with her. Because when she walks, she could walk straight and she looks okay. And so then what happened was, I'm laying there on the table and she said, wait a minute, and came back and she had a book. Well, down toward my feet is where she put the book on the table. And she kept turning pages and stopping and saying, well, let's try this. At that point, I didn't care what we tried, as long as I could get the pain to go away, because it was excruciating. So finally I said, what are you looking at? And she said, oh, it's just a book. And I said, why do you have just a book when you're working on me? I said, what's in the book? And, oh, it's just a lot of pictures and descriptions of different kinds of physical therapy. And I said, who wrote the book? Oh, a physical therapist wrote the book. And I said, well, where is this person? What's this person's name? Tell me who wrote this book. And finally I was told, well, his name is Jerry Hesch. And I said, where is Jerry Hesch? Is he in Albuquerque? Oh yes, he's here. And I said, okay, that's it. I'm done. I'm not coming back here. I've had enough. I've got to go find Jerry Hesch. If you're using his book, he probably might know what's wrong with me. And so I got off the table, put on my clothes, and said, adios, I'm out of here, and went home. And then I thought, well, where is this guy, Jerry Hesch? So I used a phone book, and I started calling all the physical therapy offices in the city. And I asked him, do you have a therapist there named Jerry Hesch? Finally, I called an office, and they said, oh, yes, we do. And I nearly fell out of my chair. I said, make me an appointment with this guy. I don't care how long it takes to get in to see him. So I saw Jerry.
And you could have walked to my office.
Yeah, because
what would it have been? 5 minutes?
Well, it was.
Or 10?
If I could walk that far, yeah. It was not even 10 minutes. It's 3 blocks away.
Yes, yeah.
And so, anyhow, I went over, and I remember the first time I saw Jerry, and I said, Jerry, can you fix me? And he's looking at me like, well, I don't know if I can fix you. Well, you better fix me, because I've had enough. And so Jerry is a very hands-on person. When he touches you, he could figure out where your problem is. And that's way better than somebody who's reading a book and looking at pictures, or who doesn't touch you at all and says, get on this bike and start riding. I mean, that's ridiculous. But in 3 sessions with Jerry, he fixed me. And I recall the first time that he worked on me, I felt like I was hit by a truck somewhere out on the freeway. I was a wreck. I mean, never had I had so much soreness everywhere. And the second time I was pretty sore too. And the third time it was better. And it was just before Christmas, and I was wrapping Christmas presents, and I suddenly realized, I don't have any pain. Then I was really afraid to move. I thought, if I move, it'll come back. So I very cautiously started walking around the room. It was pretty peculiar. At any rate, that was like 20 years ago. And I've had some reoccurrence of this. When it slips, Jerry says it rotates backwards or something. But he's shown me how to fix it, or how to deal with it. So I've tried all kinds of things to lay on, and I know he'll probably tell you what this is all about. But I found that if I roll up about 6 kitchen towels and wrap them with duct tape, and then I lay on that, it's exactly right. And it, within 3 or 4 minutes of laying the way I'm supposed to lay, it works. It puts this thing back where it belongs. And it's amazing. And why these other people are doing ride the bike and squats, I don't know. But I don't think they know what they're doing. So if you're a potential patient of Jerry's, or if you are a physical therapist learning his method, learn it because it works. And that's all I can tell you. That I'm still here, and I'm still moving around a lot.
And we still go for red chili chicken enchiladas every time I'm in town.
Yeah, we do. We do. And roast chili whenever Jerry.
Yeah, we roasted chili yesterday, green chili. Roasted that on the grill.
28 pounds of green chili.
So sometimes I earn my keep.
But trust Jerry, because this method works.
Well, thanks for your story, and I love that you just stood up and said, okay, I got to go find Jerry.
All right, I'm out of here. Well, I said,
I'm sure she was a little bit shocked.
She stood there with her mouth hanging open like, what? And I said, I'm out of here. Goodbye. And I was. I was out of there.
Well, I'm glad we were able to help you.
Yeah. Me too, because I don't know what I'd be. I think there are people in wheelchairs who have this problem that nobody can figure out what to do with. That's my feeling about it, because there are people saying, oh, I got this terrible pain, it's not in my hip, it's somewhere in my back, but it's not in my spine. What do I do? And I'm like, where is it? Show me. I'll tell you, oh, that's your SI joint. Now you need to go see Jerry, but he's a hard guy to find.
He hides out in Colorado.
Yep.
First he took off for Las Vegas for 12 years, and then he moved up to Colorado chasing grandchildren.
And my thought was, well, this is going to be an expensive fix if I can't get this together by myself, because I'll have to buy a plane ticket to go to Las Vegas, Nevada. And then that's a long way to go to see a therapist, but there was a time when I was ready to do that.
Uh-huh.
And then miraculously, Jerry would call and say, hey, I've got business in Albuquerque and I'm coming through. I'll stop by and see you. And I'm going, oh, Jerry, thank you, God almighty.
That was good timing, huh?
A miracle. So he would fix me and I wouldn't have to buy a plane ticket to Las Vegas. God. Well, we have a long friendship. And it's a good one. And I thank Jerry because I really feel like he saved my life.
Well, I'm glad we helped you that much. And you certainly paid your dues.
Yep.
So glad you finally found the care.
Yeah, me too.
Well, thanks for sharing the story. It's one of my favorite stories.
Well, thank you, Jerry.
And I don't claim to help everybody, but I certainly absolutely try very hard. And try very hard to be very, very thorough. And we're at 12 minutes, so I'll shut up now.
Okay.
Thank you.
Me too.
Thanks very much. 12 minutes is a long video.